Today's video is made possible by ADATA. Their XPG line of SSDs brings ultra-fast performance in both 2.5-inch and mSATA form factors to perfectly suit your upgrade needs. For more info, check out the link below. What's going on, YouTubers? Welcome back to Tech of Tomorrow. I'm Elric, your host, today with my co-host Nick from ASUS. And today we're going to be looking at some brand new 4K technology that these guys are bringing to the table. This is pretty interesting stuff, and I'm going to hand the microphone over to Nick, where he's going to tell you all the new details about this new awesome 4K technology. Let's rumble. So, all right, Nick, so why don't we start off with talking about a little bit of the technology that's behind this 4K monitor? Because I understand there's just a lot of interesting things that have gone into this build, correct?
Yeah, so one of the, the biggest thing right away is going to be the resolution, right? So on 4K resolution, you're going to get 3840 by 2160 on this monitor. That's really going to give you a lot more real estate. So some of the key applications that people are going to be using this with, of course, besides gaming, is going to be photography and video editing. So finally, those people that have their DSLR cameras, high-resolution pictures that they're taking them, they can finally edit them, take a look at them at a much higher resolution on their monitor at native resolution.
And with a screen this big, you'll have plenty of real estate to like spread your stuff all over the place. So people are doing a lot of editing and stuff will not only have, you know, a giant monitor, they'll actually be able to play stuff around the screen to have multi windows open at one time with that type of resolution, correct?
Exactly. 4K is technically four times the amount of 1080p pixels. So if you're going to load up a 1080p video on this monitor, you're only taking up 1/4 of the space of the monitor. So that leaves you a lot of room, whether you're watching videos or want to have multiple web pages up or multiple browser windows. You have a lot of real estate to work with, yeah.
Now, also, some of the other technologies that are behind this, I understand that like this monitor is kind of like split in half. There's actually like two screens inside of one that actually creates the 4K. Can we talk a little bit about the panel and about what actually goes into that?
Sure. So essentially, the controller that powers the panel is only going to be able to do about 1920 by 2160 at 60 hertz. So to get around this limitation and be able to offer people 4K gaming at 60 hertz or just 4K experience at 60 hertz in general. We basically have two controllers inside that do 1920 by 2160, and then we combine them back up into a single image.
So they merge to create that technology so that correct. You can maintain that 60 hertz, correct?
Correct. And that's done actually on the driver side. So on the Intel side, you go in and set up collage mode. On the AMD Infinity side, you set up the Infinity display, a 2x1. And then on the NVIDIA side, NVIDIA is actually just going to recognize the monitor and automatically tile those two displays back together.
A lot of people right now understand, but the technology is very, very new, and a lot of the drivers from all these companies are taking a while to kind of catch up. So at this point right now, some of the drivers are very kind of immature, but they're working on the technology to get going, correct?
All the major things are working. You might have some little bugs here and there that are all being worked on by the GPU manufacturers, and then we'll also have some firmware update available for the monitor soon as Visa standardization gets set for Visa 1.3,
right,
which is basically going to give all the GPU drivers or GPU manufacturers a way to recognize 4K monitors natively without having to maybe hard code specifically for one model.
Now, I understand that the panels that are used in this are actually their Sharp panels, and actually Sharp sells this monitor for actually what, close to $4,500, is that correct?
Yeah, for a little bit more and so in the professional space. ASUS, we co-developed this with Sharp, and we're selling it in the consumer space for about $3,500 MSRP right now.
So think about that. If you're out looking for this monitor, know that the same technology that goes into the Sharp monitor that costs $1,000 more is being brought down to a lower level to you folks at $3,500, which may seem a little bit pricey, but this technology is so new, it's cutting edge. And anytime anything's cutting edge, it's always pricey. I'm sure as these things go on, we'll probably see these things down in the $1,000 range, what, probably year and a half?
Yeah, I mean, it shouldn't be too long. And I think a couple other things that we can mention about the monitor in general, one of the big differences is that people that go out and buy monitors, they're really used to saying, hey, what type of panel is it? Is it a TN panel or is it an IPS panel? This is going to be a big change. So this is neither a TN or an IPS panel. This is actually
new technology altogether.
This is what's called IGZO and stands for indium gallium zinc oxide.
What? How'd you say that, Nick?
The basics, all you need to know basically is that using this new process, you can create smaller transistors and dense pack more pixels into a dense area. So this is what allows so many pixels, over 8 million pixels, to fit in one panel.
Now, one thing I have to definitely say to the audience, I don't know if any of you guys out there have monitors or big TVs. One of the biggest things that I notice about them is they get hotter than hell. There's no heat rating off this, Nick. So how are you working that? Because I'm not feeling any heat come off this monitor at all. It's actually almost cold touch.
This is a really, this is going to be the thinnest 4K monitors. There are other monitors out there, more so in the professional space, that are cost thousands and thousands more.
No.
But this is going to be the thinnest one and the most affordable one. And like you said, heat-wise, it's only going to have about an 87-watt TDP when it's operating.
Yeah, I mean, because I can feel it. It feels lower than my body, so that's pretty good. On my other monitor in my room, I have a Dell monitor, and when I touch that thing, it's a 30-inch, it's hot. I mean, it can almost burn your hands. This having no heat at all is great. I mean, if you're stuck inside of your room and you're working, you know, don't have a lot of air circulation, a hot monitor increases the temperature in your room. So this won't do that at all, because it's actually running cooler than your body temperature.
I know that we're kind of offset at an angle right now with the camera, too. So viewing angle-wise, it's going to be very similar to IPS as well. So IPS panels usually come in at around like 178 degree viewing angles. This one will come in at 176.
Well, I mean, I'm sitting here totally at an angle, and I can pretty much clearly see everything on the monitor, and I'm sitting at a very odd angle. Many of the monitors that I have, even around the house, if you get to an angle like this, the screen kind of looks kind of blurry.
And you get a lot of color shift, maybe. And
I'm seeing no color shift. I'm seeing complete even color across the monitor and even screen. But then again, you know, for $3,500, you're going to expect the best, right?
You want a quality display. So some of the other features, ports-wise, it's going to have a display port. It's going to have two HDMIs, and it's going to have a little USB port on the side, which is essentially only intended for firmware updates.
What about Thunderbolt?
Thunderbolt does not have a Thunderbolt port, no.
Okay. And I understand that you guys will have different models. This particular model doesn't have like the normal Splendid technology that some of your other stuff does. Will you guys actually have another model coming out that will have all that as well? It's kind of geared towards the gaming more?
We will have other models available. They are going to be based on different technologies, and they will likely have more ASUS-type features. Since this was co-developed with Sharp, this is kind of a bit different as far as OSD menus if you're used to ASUS monitors in the past.
We've used many of them around here, as you well know. I want to talk about something. Like, I've been looking at this like the whole time, and I'm really noticing that I don't really see any type of flicker at all. And I know you said that it's only 60 hertz, but looking at this monitor, I've been staring at it for a while. I don't even feel any really eye fatigue to strain to look at it at all. I mean, is that normal? Because, you know, usually people are like saying the 120 hertz monitors where my eyes don't strain, but I'm looking at this and I see no blurriness, no refresh at all. I mean, I suppose when the camera guys are recording, we might see some of that in there, but I'm seeing none of that through my human eyes.
Yeah, I mean, I've had a really good experience with the panel. One of the quirks is that, so if you're not in SST mode, so maybe this is a good time that we go over DisplayPort. So DisplayPort has two different modes. One that you can go through the cable with SST, which stands for single stream transport, and then it also has an MST mode, which stands for multi-stream transport. So some of those that may be familiar with daisy chaining DisplayPort, the MST is what allows DisplayPort to be daisy chained to send multiple signals through one cable.
So you could have multiple monitors up through a single connection in theory.
With DisplayPort, but essentially what we've used, and we talked about the dual controllers in the monitor, is that we're using MST mode to send two signals over one DisplayPort cable to the two controllers in the monitor. So if you're not enabling MST mode on the monitor and you're using 4K, you're going to be at around 30 hertz refresh rate.
Okay.
But once you enable the MST mode and you power the two separate panels, you can up each of those panels to 60 hertz and then join them.
Right, so it combines the two. It combines the two of them together to create an overall signal for the whole panel, correct?
And that's how you're going to get 60 hertz at 4K for the meantime, until more powerful controllers come out, maybe a year from now or a bit more,
And I mean, I'm sure as technology, you know, grows, they'll be coming up with more stuff, as it always is.
As always.
So the technology is always growing. Well, hey everybody, thanks a lot for watching. This is pretty much just the introductory video. We're just going to show you some of the technology behind this new 4K monitor. We've got plenty of stuff coming up. We're going to show you some gaming and some other stuff, so stay tuned for Tech of Tomorrow.